Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Welcome class 7 in your physics class. So today children we study about how we measure volume of liquid. The volume of liquid is measured by using a container of known capacity. The volume or space inside a container is called its capacity. Okay student, now we will study about the vessels that we use to measure the volume of liquid. Liquids like oil, milk, water, etc. To measure the volume of liquid, we use measuring cylinders, measuring beakers, burette and oil dealers measure. You can see the images of these vessels on your screen. Here you can see that it is A, the first figure is of measuring cylinder, the second one is of measuring beaker, and third is of burette, and fourth is of oil dealer's measure. So these devices are available in different sizes, such as 50 milliliter, 100 milliliter, 200 milliliter, 250 milliliter, and 500 milliliter. These are graduated and the capacity is marked on them. First is measuring cylinder. It is a cylinder generally of area 10 to the power 2 centimeter, that is 100 centimeter. It is made up of either glass or plastic. It is 10 centimeter in length with marking graduated in cubic centimeter or milliliter. In order to measure the volume, we just pour the liquid into the cylinder and then we keep the eye in line and then we measure the volume of a liquid. Next vessel that we use to measure the volume of a liquid is measuring beaker. Earlier we have studied about the measuring cylinder, and we will discuss in detail that how we measure the volume of liquid by using a measuring cylinder further in this video. Now we study about the measuring cylinder. Measuring beaker is used to measure a fixed volume of liquid from a large volume, and measuring beaker is used to measure a fixed volume of liquid from a large volume. It is available in different quantity like 50 ml, 100 ml, 200 ml, 500 ml and 1 liter. Measuring beaker are also made of glass or plastic. So these devices are used to measure the volume of liquids. Okay. Next topic is measuring volume of a liquid by using a measuring cylinder. As I have told you that measuring cylinders are containers made of glass or plastic, right? And they have calibrations on their wall and they are graduated in milliliter. And as you can see that this is a measuring cylinder, here the zero is marked at the bottom, right? And 100 marked at the top. So they are generally used in laboratories to measure the volume of a given liquid. So to measure the volume of liquid by using a measuring cylinder, first you need to understand what is meniscus. This word is new for you. Meniscus. What is meniscus? See, a meniscus is a curve in the surface of molecular substance like water. It is a curve formed on the upper surface of a liquid inside a container. When you pour some water in a container or when you pour any liquid in the container, you'll observe that liquid forms a curve, whether it will be like this or it will be like this. Okay, so always you can any liquid you can take the liquid forms a curve. Whether it will form a curve like this or it will form a curve like this. So this curve on the surface of the liquid is called meniscus. See, very common example is water. When you pour water in any vessel, then the water forms a meniscus. Okay, so suppose when you pour a liquid in the cylinder, now suppose when you pour water in the cylinder, then water always forms lower meniscus. It means water always forms this type of meniscus, and this type of meniscus is known as lower meniscus. Okay, this type of meniscus is known as lower meniscus, and this is the upper meniscus, and the very common example is mercury. This is the upper meniscus. When you pour mercury in the vessel, then the mercury forms upper meniscus. Okay, it means that the surface of the water, here in case of water, the surface bulged downwards, and in case of mercury, the surface bulged upwards. Okay, so this, where the surface bulged downwards, then it is called a lower meniscus, and when the surface bulged upwards, then it is called a upper meniscus. Clear everyone? So this is meniscus. It is a curve on the surface of a liquid, of a molecular substance. Okay, now see, this is a cylinder. Now we have to measure the volume of a liquid. Now in the first cylinder, we will pour water in it. Okay, so in this cylinder, we'll be going to measure the volume of water. So what we do, we pour a liquid into a measuring cylinder. Okay, now first you have to observe that whether that liquid is forming a lower meniscus or a upper meniscus. Okay, so this is in the first cylinder, we are going to put water in it. So obviously water makes lower meniscus. So suppose it will be like this. Okay, this is the water and this is the, now you will observe the meniscus. Now here you can see that in the case of water, this is the lower meniscus, right? So we'll measure it like we take reading from the lower meniscus from here, something like this. If you keep your eye on level, then you will take reading from this. Okay, this is lower meniscus. So we take reading from lower meniscus, and make sure that your eyes are level in the level with the container you are measuring. Okay, so here it is approximately, you can say that it is 70. So the volume of water is 70 milliliter. Okay, from here you're going to observe, you have to keep your eye on in the level with the container. Okay, now in the second cylinder we are going to measure the volume of mercury. So we'll pour mercury in this cylinder, and now then what we do, we'll observe the meniscus. Now when we pour mercury, then it will form a upper meniscus like this, like, right? This is mercury. So when in case of mercury, we take reading from the upper meniscus. This is upper meniscus. So we'll take reading from upper meniscus. As you can see, when you'll observe here, by keeping your eye with in line with the container, so you will observe that it is 70 milliliter. Okay, so the very important point is that first we have to check whether the liquid is forming a lower meniscus or the upper meniscus. If it is a lower meniscus, then we take reading from the lower meniscus. If the liquid forms upper meniscus, then we take reading from the upper meniscus. Clear? Next topic is measuring volume of a liquid by using a beaker. See, measuring beaker are also made of glass or plastic, I have told you. Now, they are used to measure a fixed volume of liquid from a large volume, okay? To measure a particular volume of a liquid, what we do, we take a measuring beaker, okay? We take a measuring beaker of that particular capacity. Suppose we need to measure 500 milliliter of water, so we take the container, the beaker, of the capacity 500 milliliter. Now suppose if you want to measure the liquid 80 milliliter of water, 80 milliliter of any liquid, then you will take the beaker of capacity 80 milliliter. Okay, so then what you will do, from the you have taken the 80 milliliter of beaker, and from the water contained in a water tub, what you will do, you will immerse the beaker inside the water contained in the tub so that it gets completely filled with water till the maximum mark. Now you will take out the beaker from the tub gently so that no water splashes out. Then you will measure the liquid. What you will do, you will immerse the beaker in the container, in the container in which that liquid is kept which you want to measure, right? You will immerse the beaker in that container, and then you will make sure that that beaker will completely filled with that liquid till the maximum mark. Here we have taken the 80 milliliter of beaker, so we have to keep the beaker filled with it till 80 milliliter. Okay, then you, when you take out the beaker from the tub gently, and you have to take out the beaker very gently so that no water splashes out. Okay, then the volume of water you will get in the beaker will be of 80 milliliter. Okay students, so today we will study till here only. Read the chapter very carefully. Okay students, Allah Hafiz.